of sugar helps the medicine go down. The medicine go down, medicine go down. Just a spoonful of sugar helps the medicine go down in a most delightful way.
Hey, all you cool cats and kittens. I am terribly sorry about the sound quality of this show. It's, I'm going to go ahead and say, fucking awful. And it's entirely my fault. I'm very loud, and she is very quiet, which is terrible in and of itself. But just keep in mind, we had some technical difficulties. We got disconnected. I had a hell of a fucking time trying to get Skype to even work, on account of how I hadn't even touched that app in 6 years. So it was a bit of a struggle, and I was a little frazzled and angry by the time we actually got everything in order. So please forgive me for the sound quality. It will get better. I need to do a couple adjustments, a lot of tweaking. She's going to be very, very quiet, and I am going to be very, very fucking loud, which no one wants. I mean, if you had to choose, that's not how I'd want it to go either. So please forgive us. They will get better. The content is good, but the sound quality, absolute garbage. So please be nice. And just know that I took like 4 hours out of my Sunday after scrubbing my mom's asshole to come and do this for you guys. So just, you know, forgive me and we will do better going forward. You know, maybe I can scrub your asshole as retribution. What do you think? Maybe I'll just scrub my own fucking asshole and then I'll scrub one of my kids' assholes. And then it'll be like a 3-asshole day. Okay? All right. Okay, stay tuned. I really am sorry. I feel terrible about it, but at least it's funny and good. Ooh, that's debatable. Okay, have a good week, guys. Terribly sorry. Stay tuned.
Who
this? Oh my god. I think I might have figured it out.
I think you did. It sounds perfect.
Okay, you? Okay. It sounds just fine. So let's just...
I feel better.
I am so angry. I'm so old and so angry. Oh, it's okay. Technology's just fine. It's just fine. It's fine. It's fine. It's fine. Anyway. Okay. How are you? How are you doing?
Great. How are you?
I just can't talk. I'm not ready. I can't talk about it anymore. This has just been a fucking like hour and a half nightmare. And like, did I even fix it? I don't know.
Well, it sounds fine.
Okay. Sure. For now. We're good. Listen, oh, here's what's going to happen. I'm going to kill myself.
Okay.
And then okay. And then you are going to have to raise my children. No, you won't cry. Don't lie. You're just going to have to raise my kids. Okay.
Nobody wants that.
You know what? Nobody does want that. Well, my kids might like that. You have some energy for now, so maybe they would be into that.
Oh, I have energy, Sandra.
Yeah.
No, I don't.
You do not? Okay.
Like, seriously, I spent, like, you know, the afternoon napping, so...
I've never wanted to hit you more than I do right now. I am so fucking jealous. Was it good though? Was it a good nap? Like, was it like a nice deep sleep where you just kind of laid there until you felt rested?
Yeah, actually, Sandra, it was terrible. It was friggin' terrible. It was awful. Worst nap ever.
Even a bad nap
horrible.
Is better than no nap at all. It's okay. Don't feel bad about it.
I'm just trying to make you feel better. It was fucking awesome. I'll be honest. It was fantastic. I mean, my sweat.
Yeah.
Covered up in a blanket. I bought the cat like a new toy, and seems to be losing fluff or something, or somebody's losing fluff. Who's losing fluff?
I'm gonna guess your 20-year-old fucking cat that's gonna die any second. I think it's that one.
Okay. I took over. She actually sent me a fish, this flopping fish toy for Louie. Louie's afraid of it. And the 20-year-old cat Ellie comes along and starts friggin' wrestling with this thing. I have a picture, seriously. She's wrestling with this thing. I'm like, what the hell? She's like, what's her name? What's the old lady's name? From the Golden Girls. Now I can't remember.
Sophia?
I'll get
it. Yeah, Sophia.
No, well, yeah, but the one that's still around.
Betty White.
Betty White. She's like the Betty White of cats. That just took me like 20 years to figure that out.
That's okay. Yeah. That is okay. Okay, so I thought maybe we would talk about just anything at all that comes up organically. I really thought this was, I'm just super mad right now. I'm just really irritated and mad. I'll be so busy, like, trying to, like, cut myself that I don't think it'll really matter. So I'll have my hands full, if you know what I mean. If you know what I mean. Hang on. I'm gonna get a sip of something with alcohol in it. Just give me one sec. Just give me one sec. As you were. Hang on.
Wow.
Just hang on one sec. I just need, like, a small glass of something.
La, la, la.
Okay, I'm still here. Okay, I'm back. I got a little bit of some white wine I'm gonna pour in a tiny little jar here. And I'm gonna chug it back.
Wow,
yeah.
You're fucking full of class,
Sandra. I know, dude, but... This whole closet that's supposed to be, you know, a closet for podcasting is full of dumb shit. Like, listen, I've got bubble wrap in here. Oh, do you remember? Every time I hear bubble wrap, do you know what I think of?
Oh my God. You think of, what's his name?
Don't say his name.
Supervisor, John.
Don't say his name.
Oh, sorry. Han. I said Han.
Han? Oh, okay. Do you want to tell that story? Because every time I snap bubble wrap, I think of that.
Okay, so we had a supervisor. Now, where was he? Was he in Iraq?
I think Afghanistan.
Okay, so Iraq, Afghanistan. He was in the Middle East. He obviously had suffered some, you know, post-trauma. Now, we don't know, or we didn't know anything, or didn't even think that, and... Sandra and I found some bubble wrap and started stomping on it.
Because we're both, well, like, five. Because an adult would be like, oh, allow me to clean up this mess. And then you and I are like, bubble wrap.
Bubble wrap. And it wasn't just the small. It was like the big bubbles, I think. Wasn't it?
Yeah, that's what I've got
that
here, too.
Really make a big bang. And so we started stomping on it. And John comes running out of his office. Yeah, said his name again.
We both fucking suck. It doesn't matter. John could be a made up name. John Smith. Sure, right? Okay, go on. It's okay.
John Smith.
Yeah.
Or wasn't John Smith the guy from that movie?
We suck. Wow. We are the fucking
so
worst.
Okay, so anyway, what happened was that he comes running out of his office. And starts saying, basically, yeah, that's really great, girls, but, you know, for a guy with PTSD from, you know, being in the Middle East, and, yeah. And we laughed.
Yeah. Oh, is this giving you some kind of trauma? Tee-hee-hee. Let's do it a little bit more.
I kind of wonder, like, if he was joking, not joking, do you know what I mean? Like, he was funny about it.
Oh, he wasn't joking. I don't get
he
the impression. I don't think he was. Because if you think about what, like, fire would sound like from far away, it would sound like bubble wrap being
bubble
popped.
Wrap.
Yeah, I think maybe that was a legitimate concern that he voiced in a comical way, which we took to mean do that a little bit longer.
Well, of course, because, you know, we're idiots.
Well, we are garbage, yeah, so.
People that moved from, God, I was 20-something years ago, when I lived in an apartment, they came from Bosnia, and they said that even slamming car doors scared them, because it was just the sound.
Jesus Christ.
I know, right? You gotta think of how many people are walking around this world, but very, very jumpy.
Yes.
More jumpy than, you know, just you or I.
Yeah. I mean, we're all traumatized in our own way, but I don't think I... Yeah.
I was actually being, it was after the recent explosion in Beirut. This girl tweeted that, she went through 9/11, and she was feeling like her PTSD was, quote unquote, acting up because she, you know, saw these videos and it triggered her.
How was your smoke? Was it good?
Oh, it was fantastic.
Okay.
I really have to quit, though.
No, you don't. Don't let anybody tell you have to quit smoking ever. It's the best thing in the history of the world. And so what? You cut your life short by like 15 years and you'll be on an oxygen mask and praying for death.
Man,
what's important is the here and the now.
Cough, cough.
Yeah. Do you ever have like an inclination to want to quit smoking?
Oh, I want to quit smoking all the time.
So where's the disconnect? Because it is like the hardest thing. Well, I mean, I have been through labor.
Well, you haven't quit crack or, you know, heroin or meth.
Well, you know what? Maybe I should start to prove a point and then get off of it. And then I can come to you and say, hey, sugar, I quit heroin. Look at my new thin bod. Like, you can quit smoking now. I will prove a point.
You know,
like, I'll do whatever it takes.
That's a great plan.
Okay, let's start. I'm going to write down, get addicted, heroin. Okay.
Rehab.
I have to pay for that?
Oh, not in Canada.
Yeah, in Canada. I mean if unless you want to, like, wait in line. It's a long time to get into a rehab.
You have time.
You're right.
Your kids will eventually forgive you.
Yeah. I don't know. The Stellinator is already telling me that I'm not her real mom, so that way when she says it when she's 16, it's not going to hurt as much.
Does she really said that?
She doesn't know what that means, and she says it to both of us, because what it really comes down to is she's got it in her head that her grandma is her real mom, and her grandpa is her real dad, so neither of us will do, because...
Oh, that's right, because she thinks that she has, like, four parents, right?
Yeah, I mean, we're already a same-sex couple, so she'll go around and say, I have two moms and three dads, and it's just like, okay, let's just bring that down a notch, because I am clearly a homosexual, and there's two moms, but, like, there's not three dads. Like, we're weird, you know, we're unusual, but we're not that weird, okay? All right, like, My vagina's not a cum sponge. It's just fine the way it is. It's not accurate.
Ew.
I know, I said cum and sponge. I hate myself. I knew I was going to turn this into fucking Beavis and Butthead. I fucking knew it.
Yeah,
right?
Yeah.
Okay,
well,
what?
I'm totally good with that.
I know,
I mean,
you...
Fuck Sandra, as if we're a highbrow anyway, with anything.
Well, I am drinking white wine out of a jelly jar. Thank you very much. So speak for your fucking self.
It's okay. I'm in like a pair of sweats, and I didn't shower this morning because, you know, I fucking didn't feel like it.
Yeah, I hear that. I as well haven't showered. I've decided that I'm gonna get on the treadmill and almost fall off three times a week. Nothing exciting, except I do actually, in fact, drip sweat out of my head. Like, I thought I was just a back sweater, but my temples sweat apparently too when I'm literally running for my fucking life. While my kids, I think, are set to destroy me in every aspect of my life. Like, not all the time, you know, just like, for example, okay, today, 6.5 miles per hour or whatever that is on a treadmill. It's like fast. For me, it is very fast. And that's the time, of course, from upstairs, I hear screaming, like high-pitched screaming, which like activates my my trauma response, which is, you know, making me run faster. But at the same time, I'm like, well, what are they doing up there? You know, because when I left, do you know what kinetic sand is?
Yes.
Okay.
Oh, yes. I saw that laughing so hard.
When I left upstairs, Stella was playing with this kinetic sand, which is basically like a giant mess that ends up all over the fucking floor, and we have to sweep it every day, and then it just, every time I throw a little bit of it in the garbage, I am elated, because it's like there's a little bit less. So I'm up there, and she's cutting this sand into lines, like cocaine, and I'm just like, okay, maybe that's a glimpse into your future. I don't know, like, how do you instinctually know to do that? It's not my concern. Anyway, so they're up there fucking killing each other, and I'm trying not to fall off. And then she comes downstairs to cry at me, and I have this, like, vision of her reaching out for me, and either I fall off and fucking knock her down, or she gets her hand stuck in the treadmill and, like burns her hand off, and all that will be there is, like, a bloody stump of a fucking arm. And it's, like, it's a lot. It's a lot. So I'm sorry I took you there. I can't remember why I said that to you.
I don't know either, but it's a very, it just, you know, basically my ovaries are shrinking, and I appreciate that because, you know, I don't need them anyway. I don't want them. I don't need them. Speaking of ovaries, I am so done with being a woman. I'm not talking, I want to make, like, a transition or anything, but I'm coming back as a man in my ex-life.
Oh, yeah. Like, that, I would love to give that a whirl. What do you think that would be like? That'd be great to take a spin on a...
Now, you know, granted, I don't know what it's like to be a dude, and I'm sure that there's, like, downfalls to being a dude as well. And, you know, if anybody comments going, well, yeah, we have to, like, deal with women and stuff, you know what, just fuck off. Because we have to deal with men, and you have to deal with women, and whatever. But, like, biologically, it really sucks ass being a woman.
I have my period right now, and I'll tell you, I'm not enjoying it.
Well, I'm in my 40s, and I think I'm entering, you know, the change. And so I'm right now 11 days late. No, I can't be pregnant.
You can't?
No, I cannot.
Oh, well, that's disappointing.
No, it's not. Baron Aaron, remember?
Yeah, Baron Aaron. Aw, that's a good nickname. I like that. Probably because I made it up.
Right. No, I just said about, can I say your friend's name?
Yes.
Remember how you were going to introduce me to your friend, Baron and Aaron? And be like, Baron Aaron? Baron Aaron. Baron Aaron? Baron Aaron.
Would you date someone who had this, like, would you date an Aaron? Or would you date someone whose name rhymed? Or, like, some, like, for me, it's like, I would never date someone who had the same name as one of my siblings.
Oh, God, that would be awful.
It would be gross.
That would be awful. You know what? I actually know, people, a female Corey, I can't remember her full name, and a male Corey. So it's Corey and Corey. They're married.
Sure.
Corey and Corey.
Whatever, man. I don't know. I guess you can call out your own name in bed, so is that a perk if you really like yourself, I guess? Oh, Corey, Corey.
I can't imagine, like, saying my own name.
Yeah, over and over. There is a weird thing about saying your own name, isn't there? I don't like it.
Well, and I particularly don't like it when there's any other sugars around. There really isn't too many sugars.
No.
Honestly, there aren't too many of us.
I only know one.
I know, right?
You're it.
And I've worked with a boy sugar before, and I'm okay with boy sugars. But I don't like it when there's other female sugars around. And I know that sounds ridiculous. Well, it does sound ridiculous in so many more ways, but I don't know. I'm so used to being the only one.
You know, we've said your name like 500 fucking times.
Have we?
You just said it.
I said sugar, didn't I?
No, you said your real name. You introduced yourself as
Aaron. Oh, fuck it. Do I really care?
I just don't. It's already too late. Even like in previous episodes, you've used your real name. It's kind of like the cat is out of the... The cat is officially completely out of the bag, except for your last name. That's not out there. So you're okay.
Yeah, no. I mean, I'm good with that. Okay, so, hello world, I'm Aaron.
Does that feel good? Are you liberated?
It does, because honestly, it is so fucking hard to not say it. Here I am trying to be all covert saying, there's not a lot of sugars around. Aaron.
Right? And I asked you if you would ever date a male Aaron, and for some reason you just kind of like balled that up and just like chucked it out. Yeah, I can't say my real name except I personally just said it 17 or 18 times.
Honestly, I didn't even notice that.
Look, it's okay. It doesn't matter. It doesn't matter. You're an idiot. I couldn't work this tiny little bit of technology to even get us to hear. It took me like 2 hours, which is fucking super annoying.
Oh, Sandra, you have, honestly, I bought a new computer a few years ago, new laptop, really happy getting this laptop because my other one was old and starting to slow down. I have never had a more infuriating piece of machinery shit. It reminds me of, like, the really, really, really old, like, dial-up. My connection, like, it's so fucking slow, and I don't know what to do about it.
Get a Mac. That's my advice. I've had this computer for 10 years. I have never had one problem with it, unless I guess my kid spilled his water all over the keyboard and that kind of went wrong with it. But other than that, I've not had any problems with it at all. So unless you decide to have
That's
kids.
Unreal.
Yeah. So I think, I mean, PCs are good in their own way, but it's like an automatic versus a standard. It's just, everything is just plug and play and it's usually pretty easy. And I feel like this computer's lasted.
What's
that?
What's wrong with standard vehicles, Sandra? I'd like to know.
Nothing. Well, you clearly just have one now because you're, I think it would be fun, but it also involves more coordination than I can muster on a regular basis.
You know, it's pretty amazing how you get back to it. It's literally love riding a bike. Well, not literally because there's no pedals. Oh, I guess there are pedals, but okay, you don't move your legs in a circular motion. That would be weird. But it is like riding a bike. I hadn't driven a standard in almost 10 years and got in. Oh, my God. My sweats are molting.
Molting or molding?
Molting. I could not figure out where all this fluff was coming from. And all of a sudden, I pull up my pant leg and I have a bunch of fluff stuck to my legs and it's flying all through the air.
Are you shaving your legs? Are they stuck on prickle?
Well, I mean, it's like 2 day old prickle, right?
Oh, that's good. That's good. Yeah, that's good.
But enough where it's like, seriously, all this fluff is flying around and I couldn't figure out where it was coming from. This is what you get for buying cheap shit.
You know,
cheap friggin' sweat.
I agree. I don't have a lot of money, like disposable income. So I've decided if I buy something, I'm going to buy something that's like, have you heard of 10 tree where they like plant 10 trees and then you get to masturbate because you're like a superior person because all your shit's ethically made. Are you familiar with that? Where it's basically like
you
mental masturbation. Yeah. I had to return my pants. I'm not good at buying online. I measure myself and I'm like, oh, okay, I'm a large. And then the large comes and it's like, well, I guess I'm a medium. And then I ordered a pair of jeans from The Gap. I am really pissed at The Gap because I am not a 32. There is no fucking way I'm a 32. They were huge because they are playing to our insecurities. Because if you see the number 32, oh, well, I'm a fucking 36 everywhere else. But at The Gap, I'm a 32. It's like a psychological, it's psychological warfare is what it is. There's no fucking way.
Well,
don't
why,
do that.
That's why I like shopping.
You like what?
Marks, all of shopping at Marks. Warehouse.
Okay.
Or as a friend of mine calls it, Mark's Work Whorehouse. Because all their sizes are, I shop like down a size.
Oh, that feels, it feels good. But you know, mentally, like there's no way I'm.
I know, right?
Like for me to get a pair of jeans that fit from there, it would have to be a 30, which is really a 34. Like there's no way I'm not a 34 right now. Like maybe someday I'll be a 30 again when I get cancer and die. But I'm not now. Like that is not a legit 30. Anyway, I have a couple of very serious questions to ask you.
Oh, okay.
They're very serious. Okay, since this is our first episode, or kind of, whatever the fuck this is, do you feel that you have any goals as far as this show goes? Like, where do you see yourself in five years? I'm just kidding. Look, I read on Twitter, it's like where everybody who said they knew that where they were going to be in 2015 had no fucking idea that this was going to happen. And I could not agree more. Like, did you predict Donald Trump being the president and there was a virus that's going to fucking kill us all?
Oh, my God. The only thing that I can say that I came close to, and this is no word of a lie, but I've said it out loud to somebody. I have said it out loud to one person, but they can't be a witness anyway. I sold my house, A, because it was meant to be broke, but also, too, I had this really bad feeling that something bad was going to happen, whether it be, like, another crash, whether it be, you know, interest rate, like, super giant hike, and that's what sort of pushed me into selling my house. So I'm not saying that I thought that there was going to be a pandemic and Donald Trump, you know, for the world. I had an inkling of something. So yeah, I'm clearly I have ESP. Clearly.
Well, I'm not going to debate that. I just.
What's that?
I said I'm not going to debate that. You clearly have ESP. I mean, I just think about it sometimes, and I sit there, and I'm just like this is just life now. Like it's just mind-boggling to me. Like. There's a virus that if you get, like, it's just insane. And he's shutting down the He's fucking with the postal system in the States so that no one can vote by mail. It's like, how?
Oh my God.
How? Like, how is it that there is no one that can be like, you can't do that? Like, I'm sorry. There's no, like, he's not a king. I mean, like, there's no one around that can be like, no. Like, you're not fucking doing this. It's not allowed. You can't do that. Get the fuck out of here. No one can say that?
It's like, yeah, there's, you know, his handlers are doing, obviously, a really shitty job. Because they're not handling him well at all. But, yeah, there's nobody who's standing up to him on, you know, okay, this is odd, but Mitt Romney is the only Republican that I've really seen actually say, dude, you're over the line.
And that's fucked. One. That is completely fucked in and of itself. And, like, don't mess with the Postal Service. Like, come on. Unacceptable.
What was it that Newman said?
Oh.
When you control the mail, you control information.
And look, where are we now? It's the most important fucking service they have right now.
Really, it is.
To vote him out?
And
yeah.
I kind of wonder with, like, USPS, if it, I don't think it would ever go under. I mean, knock on wood, I don't know if possible, but if it did, you know, what would it do to Canada?
Like,
and
would we,
the world, really?
Would we follow suit, do you mean? Like, to privatize?
It would definitely be, well, I don't know if it would be more of a push for us to privatize, but you have to think about, you know, if we were getting sort of the masses of goods from the States through the mail, that there would have to be some, you know, form of job loss.
I don't know. I think they would be like, it would show exactly what would happen to us, like, if they were to privatize, which I hope they don't, because I think it's important to have good unionized pension benefited jobs for people who just don't have a fucking education, because your middle class needs to land somewhere, right? It needs to be somewhere.
Oh,
so I think it's so
God.
Important.
Don't even get me started on the fucking middle class and, like, how, I mean, essentially it's not, if we keep on the same path as we have been for, well, really decades, the middle class is going to be eroded so much. I mean, to the point, really, right now, it really exists very limited. But you cannot run an economy when you have rich and poor.
Yeah,
the rich are only 1%. How much money are they actually putting into the economy? It's all the people under that put money and run an economy.
Yep.
And you take that away, and it's just like, okay, this whole money going to people who were losing their jobs because of COVID, whether it be layoffs or losing it completely. I have no problem with getting money for it. It ends up going back into the stream of the economy anyway. I mean, yeah, we're going to pay for it in the end, but
whatever.
This is, yeah.
Like, I'll pay for it.
Something.
Tax me. Sure, tax me. I wish they would tax us more so that prescription drugs would be paid for everyone. I would rather pay more in tax.
100%. And, like, this may sound really weird for people to hear people say, tax me more. It's like Alberta. Alberta has, you know, went from a have province to a have not province, but yet they still won't raise the tax. Like, they don't have PSC. But they have zero PSC. Why would you not raise the tax? Well, I'll tell you why. It's because they're conservatives, and, you know, majority of people in Alberta, I think, are conservatives, and, oh, don't tax us.
There is I think Alberta is as close to American as Canadians get. I think they have a lot of similarities,
yes.
Like, as to how they see things. Anyway, okay.
Right.
I'm going to switch completely the subject
okay.
matter we're talking about, because my battery on my computer is going to die, much
okay.
like my soul. Okay, serious question. Would you rather date a vegan or a felon?
Well, felons would know some, you know, good ways of making, like, cooch, you know, like,
like, out of your toilet? Make it in your toilet? Is that what you're...
Yeah, like, out of, like, you know, tang and shit. I don't know. Or what do they do? Do they, like, maybe I'm sort of thinking of Two Oranges the New Black, but wasn't there an episode where they were making like their own booze, but didn't they have to like chew up stuff and spit it in a bag or something like that?
I don't want to give you a boner here or anything, but I think I could make wine out of fucking Fruit Loops if I had to. So, I mean, a little bit of bread for the yeast. You know, there's yeast in everything. Like, everywhere you go, there's yeast. So
in other words, you're saying that you'd be a great felon.
Oh, I think I would do great in prison. I'd probably get my face fucking kicked in with my beaky little mouth, but I think I would, like, if it came down to making booze and that was some kind of status, I could definitely do it. It would taste like dog shit.
You'd be like queen of the jail.
I'm not tough, though. I'm just like a soft little weasel. You know what I mean? Like, everybody I've ever met is like, oh, I'd do great on Survivor. I think I'd be pretty lucky to make it to the third week before I drove everyone absolutely fucking insane and got kicked off the island. Like,
I sort of always wonder that, like, how I would do on Survivor. I think I'd be the first kicked off. Like, I always say, if somebody goes crazy at work, I'm going to be the first one fucking shot.
See?
No doubt in my mind.
I live my life so I have to, so that he would look at me and then, you know, maybe shoot a few other people. And then by the time he reloads, to come back to me. Like, that is my life goal, is to have people just tolerate me just enough that they would look at me and maybe see someone else in their sights they would rather unload on first. That's what I'm trying for. So I'm not trying to be like a nice person. I just want to be like middle of the pack, like, don't kill me first, like, reload so I can like run away. That's my goal.
I think those are lofty goals.
I didn't say I accomplished them.
I just think it's like my singing. Honest to God, I think my singing at work drives some people absolutely insane, and I just can't help it.
Yeah, you're a god awful singer. I'm sorry, but it sounds like you're murdering cats, like you're strangling cats. But I like it. You know, it's a joy to me. I like it because it's hilarious. Do you want to do a little bit of your Ethel Merman?
You'll be great. Don't have the whole world on a plate.
Yeah, I'd bring a gun to work and shoot you.
Yeah, so I'll be the first to go.
Well... maybe I should move to your station, so that way I'd at least be second, you know?
I'm just trying to think if there's anybody ahead of me, but I think I'm pretty sure it's me.
Well, at least you're number one at something. So did you choose vegan or felon?
I don't know, because vegans, like, I don't know. It depends on their attitude. If they're all like, yeah, that has animal products in it. I'd probably go with the felon.
I would choose the felon too. Yeah.
Sorry?
I would also choose the felon.
Now, I think also to the felon, are they really like remorseful? Is it something that they did, you know, maybe when we're younger? Like, okay, there is like the possibility of rehabilitation. I don't think vegans are going to rehabilitate to be meat eaters.
No, never. I don't think so.
I know one, you know, great. She's very, very close to vegan. Very, very close. Like, no dairy. I can't remember what. She's very close. Very limited. And she's not an asshole. Which I appreciate. Because I think that there's a lot of vegan assholes out there. No offense to any vegans. But...
I think just, you know, eat what you're going to eat and then maybe just don't judge other people. But it's hard. It's easy to say that, but I'm constantly in judgment of others. So I don't really know how, like, how much my opinion matters.
Honestly, I can totally agree with that, because, you know, you see people who are going out to certain events and stuff now where I'm totally judgmental. Completely judgmental.
Like, no mask events or like.
Oh, any events. Mask or no mask. And when I say events, I mean, you know, certain sporting events that have been organized by a certain workplace.
Oh, okay.
What happened?
I don't know. We got disconnected. My internet down here sucks, which is weird because I'm so close to the modem, if that's how it works even. I don't know.
Oh, geez. I mean, I'm in an apartment and I'm like 2 feet away from my Wi-Fi.
It's okay. We're all garbage. It doesn't matter. Okay. So, okay. You took the felon. I took the felon. I am so hungry. What are you having for supper? I need to know.
I'm not sure yet.
How often do you want to record these, do you think?
As often as you want to.
Really?
Like, seriously. Oh, yeah.
Okay. Well, that sounds good.
You know, I mean, I wouldn't say on the daily, right?
No, God. Who the fuck wants to do that? I can't commit to that. I mean, like, look, it took me 7 years to realize that I could possibly collaborate with someone else ever again. So I think, you know, we'll get into the groove of things. The first show was always kind of like, you know, weird. And then I made it extra weird by being so fucking angry with the lack of any forethought to this. I just thought, oh, hey, I haven't used Skype in 6 years. It should totally fucking work just like by some miracle, shouldn't it? No, it took a little bit of tweaking, but...
If you ever want me to, like, CD in your closet.
Yeah, I would.
And I could come out of the closet.
Okay, I have a serious question for you. When did you realize you were straight, and how did you deal with it?
I always think about this. People tell me, or when people tell me, when people say, oh, I have to have a parade, but there's no straight day. I always reply to them, every fucking day is straight day.
You
like,
know,
don't be a douchebag.
I
actually had a conversation with first individual. Well, no, actually, he's Métis. And he said the same thing. Dude, how can you possibly judge you being a marginalized individual or a part of a marginalized group? How can you fucking judge? And I actually changed his mind.
Well, I was watching a documentary while I was trying not to fall off the treadmill about, I think it was called When Did You Know? Which prompted me to ask you such a stupid question, which I feel it is a kind of a stupid question, even to ask a gay person, when did you know? It's like, I personally always knew, like, I knew it was wrong, well, quote unquote wrong, and shameful, and it was something to be hidden, like, from a very early age. I think as far back as I can remember, like, my very first memories of, any kind of crush or anything was always on a girl, and I knew enough to know to lie about it. But as far as straight pride and all that nonsense that goes with that, there is so much shame attached to being gay that it's you need a pride day, because it's one day where it's like you are surrounded by the people that are also whatever, under whatever queer umbrella you want to place them, that it's for us to be together and be proud. And not, you know, in the olden days, like 20 years ago when I went to my first pride, it was like a tiny little parade. And there was just a bunch of, you know, homos in like convertibles. Maybe there was like 15 convertibles driving down. But it's changed so much because we went to pride. I can't remember if we went last year or the year before. And it is a completely different landscape than my very first pride. Now it's like, we have corporate sponsors. There were people handing out drinks for free. The banks were all there handing out all this weird fucking shitty swag. And it's like, oh, okay, I guess people have realized that we're human beings and we have money. And it became a very commercial fucking weird thing. Whereas my very first pride, it was very small. And there were people there like shit talking everyone. It was like a really weird, different situation. And now it's like very corporate and more family centered than say like... weird guy in a strap-on with a leather mask. Do you know what I mean? It's such a weird thing. So,
I kind of think which one do you prefer? Because it has been a little bit more commercial, or not a little bit, a lot more commercialized, and, you know, where people, you know, I mean, like, you know, banks aren't doing it to be all friendly with a group of people for one reason. That's for money.
Oh yeah, they want to say, oh, I saw them at Pride, I'm going to support that bank. Except the problem is most of the banks were there, which is fine. And you know what, I don't want to throw my money at people that aren't supportive of
money.
But at the same time, it's also like I see through it. Like it's very hokey and kind of cheesy, and like thanks for the queer TD bank bracelet, but you know.
I do see what you're saying though. Like, do appreciate knowing that if you do go into that particular business, that bank or whatever, that there is open support there. queen of my pillows. I was looking for pillows, and my was sort of on the list of looking. Then I saw he was like some kind of crazy evangelist, Trump-loving fuckhead.
Uh-huh.
And I won't touch a my pillow if they made the greatest pillows on earth.
No, I can't. I can't. And you know what? As much as I would love to go to a Chick-fil-A, if I ever go to the States again, which seems highly fucking unlikely at this point, because it's like, you know, it's like there's a zombie apocalypse going on there. I mean, mind you, our numbers aren't that great right now either when it comes to COVID.
Yeah.
But
I mean, what, we're up like 36 right now?
Today, yeah. There was, what, 40 on Friday?
I mean, we have, okay, now,
where the fuck are you sitting right now? You were sitting somewhere in like a dead zone. I don't know what the fuck is going on.
Oh, you know what? Honestly, everybody says the same thing, and it's my favorite place to sit, and it ends up being like the worst place. Okay. How about now?
That sounds pretty good.
Okay. So, like, when we say, like, right now, Manitoba, the province, has 200 active cases. 205. I'm sure that they would lost their out of the cost because, like, we're kind of, like, I'm freaking out. But again, the numbers are getting too high for my liking. And yet, in comparison, but you can't compare. You can't compare fucking Manitoba.
It's nothing. Our density is nothing. It's a huge province.
Huge province, huge country where, you know, space is our... Well, space is our friend. I think it always has been, actually, to be honest.
Yeah, it's one of the perks to living in this province, except for at my house, but our houses are very close together over here.
It's pretty funny. Oh, shit, I'm in an apartment. I mean, I can hear when somebody next door shower. So, like, honestly...
If only someone would have advised you to choose a building with concrete walls. Like, why wasn't there a friend that would say that to you?
Shut up. I think... I didn't be advised of that because I lived in
like, the apartment building. You sound like fucking R2-D2 right now. I can't hear... I can hear every third syllable. This is like... I love technology, isn't it great? Poor connection. Fuck you, you piece of shit. Sorry, not you. Not you. Not you, my computer. Not you. Not you.
Am I good?
Yeah, now it's better. Much better.
I'll just keep on walking around.
No, no. Okay, we're going to wrap this up.
My steps into the day.
All right.
We're going to wrap it up?
I think we can. I mean, the only other thing I wanted to talk to you about is perhaps nothing.
Wow.
Look.
That's
well, the other things I wanted to say, like to talk to you about were like, they're really long conversations. And it's, you know, I want you to enjoy a little bit of freedom before we put that yoke back on and go to work tomorrow.
Oh, well, I can't wait for the long discussion. I mean, it's a good one. We can talk about a little bit of COVID, and then we went lowbrow too with bubble wrap and PTSD.
Right, full gamut. Right, this is going to be a great show. Yeah, I agree. I think we can, and I think we will.
Can I say one last thing? And it sounds really deep, but that's the club because for the U.S. So for your U.S.
Okay.
You can actually text USPS to 50409, and they will send letters to your senators and representatives in support of the postal system.
Okay,
you
well, I didn't know.
50409. You know, I haven't felt so passionate about too many things, but seeing like what's going on with the U.S., it's pretty scary for them, for the social system, but also for democracy. Save democracy now. It's really fast with the post service, and that's, you know, being one to be supportive of that. I mean, because, you know, posting, but also too because, you know, it's saving democracy. So make sure you text that because we can't do it as Canadians either. So. Yeah.
We're just kind of spectators, like very encouraging spectators, like right is right and wrong is wrong, but. It's hard to watch. It's like watching your family like go through a real shit show that no one wanted. Like no one wanted him.
Right.
And even the people I think that voted him in, I think a lot of them have changed their minds. Like I think about how many people would have voted him in who now have family members that have died of COVID because of his complete and total
Right.
Inaction. Just complete denial.
Well, I follow a couple of people on Twitter, or a couple of groups on Twitter that I don't even know what they call them. But it's Republicans against Trump, and then people who have Republican in the past who are registered Republicans who say we're voting for Biden.
And look, I'm not really ecstatic about Biden either, but it's what you've got, you know?
Candidates who think what the worst... Okay, no, I don't... Sardine. A fucking can of sardines versus Trump. The can of sardines are going to get my vote over Trump. Oh, my God.
Absolutely. Anyone but him. It doesn't matter really who it is, but, you know, like, 15-year-old me remembers the Anita Hill thing and the way he treated her, and I just remember watching that and being so fucking angry. And he was one of the guys that really got up there and gave it to her about how she was trying to, like, ruin this successful black man's life and career. And it's like, you know what? Fuck you. But I mean, at the same time, people change, times change. What norms are different now than they were, you know, 20, 25 years ago, but...
So hard because, you know, like on the one hand, yeah, you do want to have the perfect candidate, but it doesn't exist. I mean, if you look through, Liz Warren probably has a fairly clean track record, but you know, you could still find shit on her. You know, you could find shit on Bernie, you can find shit definitely on Trump.
Yeah, and you know what? Who hasn't said a bunch of dumb shit that they regret? I mean, not everybody has a podcast with, like, recorded mementos of terrible fucking stupid things that they've said, but I have that luxury. So as much as I, you know, enjoy...
Fuck. We're not going into, like, any kind of politics.
Right. I was trying to end this, like, 10 minutes ago, and then I started talking about Biden. Anyway, thank you so much for doing this with me. I don't know what drug you've taken to agree to it, but I'm going to take it, and... Thank you very much. And
I'm
you're
high on life, man.
Life. Only right. Life?
Well, we'll do it again whenever you want.
Okay. Well, that's exactly what I wanted to hear. All right. Thank you so much. Have a good night.
You too, Sandra. Talk to you later.
Goodbye. Okay,